Welcome to ISC Plus One class. Today we'll continue lesson 3, Economic, Social and Cultural Impact of the British Rule. Before going through the lesson, we will understand the objectives of the lesson. The objectives are to understand the impact of modern ideas of Europe on Indian administration, reform movements, Brahmo Samaj, the Arya Samaj movement, Sir Syed Ahmad Khan and Aligarh movement, struggles against caste, in which we will study about the contribution of Mahatma Jyotiba Phule, Narayan Guru and Varisalingam Kandukuri, then abolition of sati rights, widow remarriage act of 1856 and female infanticide prevention act 1870 and the age of consent bill 1891 with its impact of the age of consent bill. We had already discussed about the impact of modern ideas of Europe on Indian administration. In the last session, we had also discussed about the Brahmo Samaj. In today's session, we are going to discuss about two religious movements, the Arya Samaj movement and Sir Syed Ahmad Khan and Aligarh movement. Before going ahead, we will go through the new terms of this lesson. Ascetic, a person who remains away from all forms of indulgences, purged to remove people that you do not want from some organization. Renegades, a person who leaves one group to join another that has very different views, hitherto until now. Unflinching, determined even in difficult situation. Aristocracy, the people of the highest social class. And the last term is inhibitions, a shy or nervous feeling that stops you from doing or saying what you really want. So first we will discuss the reform movement, Arya Samaj movement. Arya Samaj was founded by Swami Dayanand Saraswati, whose real name was Mool Shankar. He was born in 1824 in Gujarat. He led the life of an ascetic. We had already discussed. Ascetic is a person who lead highly self-disciplined life and who stays away from the comforts of the life. Swami Dayanand Saraswati was given credit for mainly three things. He set up Arya Samaj in 1875. To popularize his Arya Samaj, he published a journal called Satyarth Prakash. And he also set up the Anglo-Vedic institutions. These were the educational institutions where the ancient Vedic education was given in English language. In last session, we had discussed about Brahmo Samaj. And in this session, we are discussing about Arya Samaj. There were basically two differences between both these reform movements. The Brahmo Samaj interpreted the scriptures in the light of Western rationalism, and it was inclined towards Western values. Whereas Arya Samaj interpreted the scriptures in the light of Vedas, and it was inclined towards Indian ancient values. So Brahmo Samaj was more influenced by the Western secular, rational, logical ideology, whereas the Arya Samaj cherished the ancient ideals. And Arya Samaj also believe that Vedas are the true source of knowledge. Now we'll go through the principles of Arya Samaj. The first principle is God is source of true knowledge. So by saying this, Arya Samaj has discarded the idea of priesthood. Then the second principle was that God is immortal. He has never taken birth and he will never die. Then they believe that Vedas are supreme. We don't have to go to Western countries to attain knowledge. Our Vedas are the true source of knowledge. According to Arya Samaj, Arya Samaji should follow truth. A person who follow the Arya Samaj or Arya Samaji should not follow the wrong path. Then actions according to Dharma, a person should know what is right and wrong and then choose the right action. Arya Samaj believe in well-being of all, that all human beings should be treated equally and they should be developed equally. Arya Samaj believe that justice should be done to all. There should be no exploitation on any basis. Then Arya Samaj believed that ignorance should be dispelled and it is the duty of every person to ignite the light of knowledge inside him. Then Arya Samaj also believed that it is the responsibility of every one of us to do self-progress. And lastly, Arya Samaj believed that if we had to choose between social interest and individual interest, we should always give importance to the social interest, the interest of the society. Now we will discuss contribution of Swami Dayanand Saraswati. Mainly he has contributed in two spheres, social and religious sphere, and we will also discuss his contribution in political sphere. In social and religious sphere, Swami Dayanand Saraswati condemned untouchability and casteism. Untouchability was a practice which was used in the ancient times, according to which the upper caste Brahmin used to treat the lower caste very badly, and if by mistake they used to touch the body of the upper caste, they used to say that they have become impure. So Swami Dayanand Saraswati refuted this idea of untouchability and casteism. He was of view that the renegades should come back to Hinduism, those people who have deserted Hinduism and adopted Christianity or some other religion should come back to Hinduism. And for that, he has started a movement called Shuddhi Movement in Hinduism. He criticized child marriage and polygamy. He was not in favor of early marriage of the child, and he also believed that a person should not have more than one wife at the same time. Swami Dayanand Saraswati set up Anglo-Vedic educational institutions, and at modern times all the DAV schools and colleges are the product of Arya Samaj. Then in political sphere, Swami Dayanand Saraswati infused or awakened the political awakening among people. He motivated Lala Hansraj, Pandit Gurudat and Lala Lajpat Rai. All these were the freedom fighters. Swami Dayanand Saraswati, by his Arya Samaj, gave birth to extremist nationalism. This is a group of freedom fighters who believed in taking up weapons against the British rule. Now, in today's session, we will discuss one more religious movement, that is a Muslim movement started by Sir Syed Ahmad Khan, and we will also discuss the Aligarh movement. Sir Syed Ahmad Khan was born at Rai Bareilly in 1817. He saved the lives of many Englishmen and Englishwomen during the revolt of 1857. So he was awarded knighthood. As a knighthood, he was given the title of Sir in 1888 by the British government for his loyalty towards the British Empire. In 1857 revolt, Muslims took a leading role. So British treated Muslims as their enemy. As a result, government jobs were denied to Muslim community. So Muslim aristocracy or the Muslim zamindars or the nobles or the rich class reduced in society. Western education was introduced by the British government. Hindus and Muslims reacted differently to Western education. Hindus welcomed Western education, they adopted Western education, they thought that the Western education was meant for their development. So they got higher jobs in the administration, and as a result they became modern and economically developed. Whereas the Muslims discarded Western education, they believed that the Western education was meant for polluting their religion Islam. So they were not given the government jobs, and as a result they became socially economically backward as compared to the Hindu society. Seeing this miserable position of Muslims in society, Sir Syed Ahmad Khan advocated Western education for Muslims. He said, "It is not written in Quran to not to learn English," and he asked the people to believe only in Quran and not the other commentaries of Quran. So he asked the people that Quran is not against learning the Western education, so Muslims should equip themselves with the Western education. He denounced polygamy. He was also against marrying more than one woman at the same time. And he was also against giving talaq to Muslim women on any pretext. He worked for the women education and end of parda system in the Muslim society. Sir Syed Ahmad Khan advocated Western education. We have already discussed this. He had a political insight, a political thought behind this also. As Hindus have welcomed the Western education, so Sir Syed Ahmad Khan believed that English educated Hindus would be more in the government jobs. So with the passage of time, the Hindus would dominate the Muslim, and in future, if the British government would leave India, the government will be transferred its power to the Hindu society. So in India, there would be Hindu Rashtra in which the Hindus will exploit the Muslims. So he asked the Muslims to get Western education, and how he asked Muslims to get Western education, that we will discuss now. He set up Aligarh Scientific Society in 1864. Then he set up Anglo-Oriental College at Aligarh in 1875, where most of the staff of this college was European. And at present, this college has developed into a leading university in the education of medical sciences. It is Aligarh Muslim University at present. Slowly and slowly, the campus of Anglo-Oriental College developed into a political arena, and Aligarh movement and Muslim separatism in India developed here. No doubt, Sir Syed Ahmad Khan has asked the Muslim to take the Western education and promoted some reforms, but there were very drawbacks of his contribution that we will discuss now. His attitude was narrow. He was concerned about only Muslim community. He was not concerned as Indian as a whole. Then when he propagated Western education, there was a sense of political insecurity in him that if Hindus will learn English, Hindus would dominate the Muslims in future. He was only concerned about the Muslim aristocracy, that means zamindars and nobles, and he did not care about the poor Muslim people. He had great contempt for Hindu English educated middle class, and he also disliked Indian National Congress. He has given his views in his journal Pioneer, where he condemned the working of Indian National Congress. Along with Muhammad Ali Jinnah, Sir Syed Ahmad Khan gave the theory of two nation theory, and he also became helpful in setting up the first ever Muslim party in India, Muslim League, which ultimately led to the partition of the country. So Sir Syed Ahmad Khan was only in favor of nobles and zamindars, and he had no concern for the poor Muslims and peasants. I hope you have understood till here. With the help of these notes and internet, you are advised to make the notes of the above topic. Thank you.